become shouldering, and well, I won't tell you what the other one is, but what is good is to do it without bend, and to get it really good without bend one way or the other. Now, do you think you could try some of that in sitting trot? Okay, now a bit of the secret, just come here for a minute. Bit of a secret in the trot is to take your leg back a bit, but not to press with it, just to take it a little bit further back. So like almost like you've just done there. And then back and then just play with it a bit. This could be where the saddle might not help.
Yes.
So take your right leg, your inside leg back, and have a little conversation with it, with your leg. There, very good. Now he's just moved his quarters over. Well done. Did you get that on the video?
Yes, I think I did.
So just try that again. So leg back and a little wriggle with it when it's back. And now, which rein will straighten his neck, do you think? Yeah, exactly. So now we want to be on, you see, very good. This is perfect. A little shake of the left rein and a shake of your right leg. So it's opposite. It's the inside leg back and your outside rein. And a little bit of communication. So you slide the leg back. Right back, another little bit back, a few centimetres further back. Very good. Again, a few centimetres further back. And let the front legs come in a bit. Yes, there. Whoopsie. Okay, it was good. I don't know what happened at the end though, because he moved in a bit off the track. One more time. Good. Nice trot. Front legs towards me. Neck straight, front legs here, very good. Right leg sliding back and wriggling, not pressing, very good. Perfect. Now, exactly, super, okay. And now walk. Oh, good boy. A little bit of a stretch and change the rein in walk. That was very good. You got it spot on this long side. That's it. Slide that leg back. That's very, slide it back in. When you feel it's just about to come in, wriggle your heel. Yeah. Very good. And try to wriggle your foot of your inside leg rather than lean in and tense up. Or try with your upper body not to feel any difference. Just turn in, look to the other side of the school. That's perfect. Look at the P marker. Across the other side of the school. So basically, look between his ears into the angle that you want him to be on. I'm just gonna try it again. The trot's very nice. Yes, very good. Sliding the leg back and wriggling the foot. And look up and across the school. Wriggle that leg, keep wriggling it. Because he's stepped in a bit. Yeah. Let me see your inside foot move. Like you've got a stone in your shoe. That's it. Like that. That's right. Very good. Well done. Now let's do the other one, the head to the wall. Good. So slide the leg back. And give that a little bit of a wriggle. Exactly. That's right. And sort of face the wall. Look at the wall. That's very good with these quarters. Very good, very good. Okay, okay, very good. All right, now nice trot. Just trot down alongside normally now. Keep your head up, look up. That's it. That's right. Okay. Okay, now let's have a big circle and let's get him ready to try some canter. And we'll just have a look at his canter. Now think about, we don't want his head to be outside now, so think about now where he is looking. On the circle, we want him looking a little bit to the inside. Do you think that's to the inside? What do you think? You tell me. I'm not saying he is, and I'm not saying he's not. So, exactly. Exactly. Right. Right. Very good. That's right. Now then, now we've got to get him into canter. So just think, is he feeling canter? And then when he is, then ask him. Good. Left hand. So he just chased the wrong canter, didn't he? Why don't you lift your inside hand up a bit and have that inside bend. Okay. Keep playing with your inside hand. Good. Now, what do you think about his head? We need to make an adjustment to his head. Do you know what it is? No. It's too low and too tucked in. So what are we going to do about that? Yeah, well, actually, it just came up when you hit that wall. So play with your hands upwards a bit. That's it. That's it. Just play with those hands up. Yeah. Now it's slowly coming up. Give him a little bit of vibration up towards the roof. There we go. That's getting better. If you want to slow it down, just use your voice. But your hands mustn't. There. That's got him up now. That's better. Good. Good. Ah, well done. So that has let him come up. All right. And now into trot. Use your voice to trot so it's smooth. Okay. Now I want you to change the rein and then I want you to show me the canter the other way. That's right. That's right. And good, he's lifted his head up. That's where, when you look on the video, that's where you want his head. So it's just right. Of course it can be too high, but it also can be too low. Very good. Now we sweep, come here. We've got to think about the circle and whether he's bending to the inside. Come on, here. Come on, here. So, what do you think? Is he bending to the inside? Not really. Think about a bit of leg yielding, where you move him a bit to the outside from the inside leg, like that. That's very good. Right, very good. And it's still a good height of head. Now, I'm pretty sure when you're going to canter that he's going to put his head down. So you've got to be thinking about how can I persuade him not to stick his head down. So get that in your head. The outline is good. Think of the leg yielding to the outside. It's a nice trot. Now, a couple of voice aids and then into canter. Think about his head. What? Yeah. Now, that was really good where you lifted your hands there. Exactly. All right. So play with that inside hand high to say, come on, have a little chat with him. Say hello with that down the rein. Exactly. Bit higher because it's stopped being high. There, good, good. All right, all right, all right. Okay, and into trot, voice. Very nice, very nice. And into walk. Okay, so if you look back on your video, just as you went into that first stride of canter, you actually did this, and that is the start. If you keep your hands down and do nothing, his head will stay down and won't change. So we have to experiment and have a conversation and say, hey, could you lift your own head up? Can you lift it up? And we don't know how we have to use the reins, but we have to try, we have to experiment. And whatever works is we think, okay, that's the way I'm gonna do it then. Now I think the key exercise for you to practice is leg yielding from, you see the distance you are now from the wall on your left. You want to start on a circle that is about 2 meters from each of these three walls, and in trot going and think about that. Going to try and trot. You're going to get your sat nav working on this circle that is 2 meters from there, and then you're going to say to me now. And when you say now, you're going to try a few little tiny steps to a slightly bigger circle. But you don't have to go from there to the wall. You can just go a little bit like that, and then somewhere else on the circle, you can go a little bit more out. Okay? Come on. But this is, we're going to practice this, and we're going to call this practicing being upright. Okay? So, let's give it a go. Now, of course, if his head is to the outside, it's going to cause a problem, because he'll lean in as well. So he's got to be looking to the inside. So you must be able to see the corner of his inside eye by not looking down, but by him turning his head towards you. Now, exactly, I liked it. Do it again with your hands. Yeah, rather than taking hands to the outside, that was a good idea, but it's better you don't do that. Just play, shake that inside. Imagine you've got a bell in your right hand and have a little ring of the bell and say, come on, listen to me, look at me, turn to the inside without you turning. That's it. Every few meters, I want you to do exactly what you've done with your hands. Perfect. And look what he said. He said, oh, I'll lift my head up and I'll look to the inside. Do it again, every few meters. I don't want you to keep your hands still. Very good. Very good. I don't want you to keep your hands still. I want you to do that every, good. Do it again. Very good. Do it again. Do it again. Okay. And he's looking to the inside and his body staying to the outside. Very good. The only trouble is we're getting actually smaller with the circle, aren't we? But you are doing a very good job. So what you need to do, keep your eye on him sometimes and think, actually, where is his neck? Is it very straight? Or is it there a little bit of a bend? And then when you've looked at him, then look up and around and think, okay, where am I about to go? And just do, so looking is two different things. Looking at him, looking around. Looking at him, looking around. Exactly. And operating your hands as well. But his neck, perfect. That was right. Very good. That's going to be your party piece. But you've only done it once on the circle. I want it 4 times on the circle. Shake, lift your hand up. Operate. It's like operating a puppet. Very good. Excellent. Now the big question, and now look, now that is how you get to the bigger circle. So I want you to do that. So actually do it, lift your hand up, have him looking to the inside, make him look to the inside, do it with your hands, shake, and now he'll go sideways, very good. Lift your hands up. Good. Perfect. That's it. Right. Now you've really started to school him. What you did there. And what a lovely uphill trot. Now, the big, very good. And I didn't even remind you that time. Now, you've got to do this in canter. Right, now we don't want any motorbiking leaning in, right? But the secret is to do that with your hands, because if he's looking in the right direction, he won't be tilting in, and then you won't tilt in quite as much. But remember, in canter, you're going to also practice leaning to the outside, sitting in the middle. So, hands up, play with your hands. Help him go into canter, play with your hands as you go into canter, which you were very good. Okay, coming towards the video, lean to the outside, but lift your hands up. Yeah? Okay. Now that's not quite leaning. If you look on the video, you'll see what you did there, look at the back of me. You actually dropped this shoulder and you actually went that way. So lean means, I'm gonna fall off this way. So fall off to the left. No, don't actually fall off, but think of that. And you did a perfect, not backwards, don't fall backwards, sideways. So, if there was a wall here, look at me, if there was a wall here, I want you to hit the wall with your head. So like that. Okay, or do it on that wall. Shake your hands up because we need him looking to the inside. Get your stirrup. Hold on, let's get your stirrup, don't you? That's it, very good. What about the hands? You need to just shake him up so he looks to the inside. Right, okay, now get out of the large circle by lifting your hand up. And then let's have your head bobbing against the wall. Yeah, very, yeah, without collapsing your shoulder. Okay, now the little, lift your, yes. Yes? Okay. You're doing well. So, when you hit your head against the wall, I want you to be nice and tall. So, I want you to hit a little bit higher the wall with your ear. Yeah? Good. Good. And now let's have a little bit of a shake with that inside hand so we get him under control. Yeah? And you know what? Yes! And you're in the middle of it. Now, that looks great. Now look terrible again and lean in towards us. Right? Very good. Now correct yourself. Very good. Lift your hand up. Good. Lean in. Oh, actually do it towards the camera so you can have a... Mask it up. Bring him upright. Inside hand. Good. Play with that inside hand. Exactly. That was perfect. Perfect. All right, boys, it's a trot. Now, we need to mark that video. When I said that was perfect, you need to replay that several times tonight when you get home or when you're going back in the truck. That point, you can walk now, and we're going to try that on the other end. You really played with your hands. He had his head to the inside. He took himself to the outside, and you sat straight above it. Walk. That's it. Through the circle, change the range. I know. Thanks. Okay, are we ready? So just before you trot, just make sure that inside rein is working to bring his head up. And sometimes when you've been working for some time, you have to do it a little bit more because they go to sleep a bit, they'll get a bit tired or not off in their brain, so you have to be. That's very good. Very good. Yeah. Excellent. Now you look at the video now from the back, and your spine is straight up above his spine. I don't mean straight, you don't need to stiffen up. What I mean is, if you had x-ray vision, you'd see the spine was above his spine. Very good. And he's looking to the inside, isn't he? Exactly, exactly, exactly. Now the only thing is, we don't want to hang our hands down here because he will do exactly what he's just done there, which is like, fall down. So yeah, exactly, that's right. Now we've got to say to him, come on, carry your own head up. the pole between his ears is going to lift it up. Right, very good. Right, that's perfect. So now we're just going to do the same thing in trot and then the same thing in canter. Off we go. Yeah, good. Now what are we going to do with the hands? Exactly. Right. I like it. I like it because you are experimenting and you are straight up above him there. Perfect view from the back. I was just going to remind you that his head was getting a bit low. Now will he go sideways? Needs to go out to the big circle, but that's right. Okay. Well, you can do that easily enough in trot. Let's do the same thing in canter. And I was watching your hand then as I was talking, and you were just letting your hands float up. Where are we sitting? Exactly. Both hands up. Help him stay up. Good. Look down at him. Look up around the school. Look to the outside. That's it. Look at the window reflection. Okay. Now that was brilliant because I didn't even tell you to do that with your hand. And he is starting to look to the inside and taking his body to the outside. And you are not motorbiking in. Look at his neck. Look to the outside, look around. Very good. Very good. Coming to the camera, lean in. Do it wrong. Do it right. Very good. What about his neck? You've got your body and your hands to think about. Two things. And his neck. Well, to get your hands right, his neck will be right. Yeah? Good. Very good. Exactly. Do it wrong. Yeah? Nearly forgot which way to go. Do it right. Okay, and into trot. You were absolutely perfectly above him then. Yeah, very good. Now into trot. Yeah, where are you now with your body? Good, look at his neck. Is he bending in the neck? Ask us, there we go. Okay, have your reins a bit shorter. Good, very good, very good. Perfect, his neck, his pole came up. And now into walk. A walk. Just loose way. Right, so the good thing is you can do it wrong and you can do it right. And that's really important. That, come over here now. It's not, like I said before, it's